and welcome to MTV's news update for today, Tuesday, May 16, 2017. I am Trisha Ramlal with your top headlines for tonight. Linen Town Council needs $200 million bailout from government. Cancer is the main cause of mortality in Guyana. Stephen Vera nowhere to be found as Kanu continues to search. Rosal sugar workers stage mass protest against the estate's closure. Municipalities conference to be held to foster development in the nine towns. And in court, former soldier to stand trial in the High Court for rape. Now for the news and details. Residents of Marikabai, the only indigenous community located in Region 5, were afforded the opportunity to raise concerns with Vice President and Minister of Indigenous Peoples Affairs, Sidney Alicock, who visited the community. During a meeting with the residents, Minister Alicock reminded them that they were not forgotten, adding that the government is working assiduously to foster development within hinterland communities. Minister Alicock told residents that the government is currently crafting a development master plan. This includes providing proper infrastructure, education, healthcare, and other pivotal social services. One of the issues raised was the need for internet access. The minister also pledged to give the community $200,000. More news still ahead, do stay tuned.
Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Rice farmers, my name is Wilford Adams from BLT Enterprise Inc., Guyana Real Rice Crop Enhancer. Return to a higher production and productivity in rice by embracing the BLT Balanced Nutrition Concept. It is the only way. Let BLT 625-25 and 832-16 along with our stabilized urea and micro elements take you to the mountaintop. Do not be fooled by imitation fertilizer in fancy bags. Not because you are getting credit, it means that you must accept garbage. You have rights too. Call 624-1440 for more information. Thank you and God blessings upon you.
At GBTI, quality customer service is our number one goal. That's why with our safe deposit boxes, we give you the comfort of knowing that your valuables and important documents are safe and secure at all times. Boxes are available in different sizes at all of our branches. GBTI,
your friend, your bank.
Guyana! Guyana! The Central Housing and Planning Authority, under the patronage of the Government of Guyana, brings to you Housing Solutions 2017 and Beyond Expo, a model village of modern, stylish, and affordable housing designs. Prospective homeowners, here is your opportunity to engage with the banking and other financial institutions as well as insurance companies to discuss available financing options. The public will experience and enjoy wholesome entertainment for the entire family and savor the flavor of local and foreign cuisine as well as beverages at the food court. So tell a family, tell a friend and come visit Model Village. Housing Solutions 2017 and Beyond opens on Friday, May 26 at 15 hours and runs from May 27 to 29, time 11 to 22 hours each day at the Perseverance Housing Development Site on the east bank of Demerara. Not too sure where that is? Just follow the Massey and Princess Hotel Road. This event is sponsored by Geico Construction, Guyana Bank for Trade and Industry, Republic Bank, Turgonal, New Building Society, and Quartz.
Expo, be there.
Production is slated to begin in the year 2020. The government is currently putting all measures in place to accommodate the newly found resource. This is according to Natural Resources Minister Rafael Trautman.
The Minister of Natural Resources Rafael Trautman said that the production of oil in Guyana, which is being facilitated through U.S. oil giant ExxonMobil, is slated to start formally in the year 2020. He said that the government is putting measures in place for the process to begin.
The government has been working with the companies assiduously to prepare Guyana for that. Part of those preparations mean that we, apart from meeting them individually on a weekly basis, we've been going around the country also sensitizing Guyanese about what is happening, and we are working as best as we can, as fast as we can to prepare. Well, production is slated to start formally in 2020, but before that we have a number of things that have to get done. One, we are reviewing an application for production license and a development plan. That is how the well will be structured, how many wells, the facilities that will be on board, how many Guyanese will be employed and so forth. So that is under review now.
The minister also disclosed that a Dutch company, SBM Offshore, has accepted a contract to construct an offshore storage vessel.
I can say as well that a contract has been given to a Dutch company, SBM, to construct the vessel called the Floating Production Storage and Offloading Facility. That work will start in November this year and will finish close to 2020. Contracts have also been given out for what is known as undersea cables and piping and so forth. So things are happening.
Guyana's unproduced resource has been found by U.S. oil company ExxonMobil in 2015. The oil company in May of that year announced a significant oil discovery on the Stabroek Block, located approximately 120 miles offshore Guyana. In 2016, and again in March 2017, more oil was discovered at the Snook Well. However, outspoken economist Raymond Gaskin had declared that the country will not benefit from oil production. He had also on many occasions called for the oil contract to be made public, but the Natural Resources Minister had claimed it was not necessary. The opposition leader Barrett Jagdeo had also commented, saying that oil in the hands of the coalition government is not good for the country.
The government continues to maintain that it will not become dependent on oil and gas when it begins producing the natural resource in 2020. Recently, Minister of Natural Resources Rafael Trautman assured residents of Region 2 that agriculture will remain an important sector to the country. For this year alone, the government will be expending $18 billion in the agriculture sector. The allocation will go towards improving the drainage and irrigation systems, livestock and fisheries sectors, and the promotion of hinterland agriculture, among other projects. Minister Trautman added that the government is aware of the importance of other sectors to the country and will ensure they are maintained with the revenues generated from oil production. With cancer cited by the Public Health Ministry as the main cause of morbidity and mortality in Guyana, capacity will be strengthened to address non-communicable diseases countrywide.
Following the conclusion of the three-day session, medical personnel will be more knowledgeable about early detection, diagnosis, and treatment of common cancers, as well as comforting care. PAHO WHO representative Dr. William Adukro says it took the organization 2 years to source professionally acclaimed personnel to train the local medical practitioner.
From the fact that we don't even have people trained in the to manage effectively these cancers. We have people who are really working hard, our general medical practitioners who are working hard in the areas of cancers, but we need them to be upgraded in appropriate management of the cancers, as well as also in the appropriate provision of palliative.
There is also need for the implementation of a national cancer plan in an effort to upgrade the monitoring as well as the population increases, explained Dr. Adukro. According to information from the Cancer Registry, taken treatment for cancer was low, as 79% of cases had no treatment recorded. Data also show that breast, cervical and uterine cancers cause the most deaths among women. On the other hand, prostate and colon cancers are the leading causes of cancer-related deaths in men. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
Coming up, Stephen Vera nowhere to be found as KANU continues its search. And Food and Drug Department yet to contact the distributor of dosed patent barley after the product was found to be adulterated.
Check us out at Home Sense Wholesale and Retail, 31 Traquay Farm, East Bank, Demerara, for your household items such as carpets, mats, vases, stand fans, kitchen utensils, etc. We have in stock office chairs, plastic chairs, tents, outdoor patio sets, trampoline, children's swings, and much more. Also remember to check out our second branch at 93 Grove Public Road. Visit us today for the best deals and amazing prices on adult and children footwear, undergarments, children book bags, lunch bags, bicycles, beach chairs and accessories, baby care items, and a whole lot more. So the next time you're thinking about going shopping, remember to visit Home Sense Wholesale and Retail. Telephone numbers 638-6861 or 619-8502. We're standing here looking at each other, baby.
In today's fast-paced world of modern finance, with its many options and opportunities, you will need good advice and help getting value for your money. Hand-in-Hand Trust is the way to go, from owning your own home or business, with our residential and commercial mortgages. We'll help you realize your dreams. You can also access investment deposit accounts, share brokerage services, personal trust, thrift and pension plan trusteeship, property management, investment portfolio management, safe deposit boxes, the convenience of our Cambio, Western Union and Bill Express services. Hand in Hand Trust for financial services and more. Helping you get the most out of your financial resources and your life.
Compares to the class and beauty of Beeson Windows and Doors, engineered by professionals and built to last longer than the competition. Buy 10 windows and get one 24 by 16 bathroom window absolutely free. No tricks, no gimmicks, and no hidden fees. Prices starting from 13.5 VAT inclusive. So visit our showroom today at Lot 1228 New Eccles Industrial Site or BPAT's building on Regent Street and save big on UPVC or aluminum windows. To order now, call 622-4197 or 226-1292.
Give it to me, my girl.
The news continues on MTV. Further works on the east coast of Demerara Arch will continue this Sunday, May 21 from 10 to 14 hours. These works will see the installation of lights on the arch. As a result, the East Coast Highway between UG Access Road and Ogle Access Road will be closed to vehicular traffic. Motorists and pedestrians are asked to take note and exercise caution and pay attention to all directional signs in the area. The Customs Anti-Narcotics Unit has revealed that well-known biker Stephen Vera is listed as a representative for the shipper Naren Lal following a drug bust on Friday last. Searches were conducted for the men by the unit for questioning, however, those were unsuccessful. Details in this report.
Commander of D Division, Leslie James, during a telephone interview, says the matter is out of the police control. He noted that the matter is under the purview of the Customs Anti-Narcotics Unit, CANU, which has arrested persons suspected to be involved following the major drug bust on Friday last at Silat, East Bank, Essequibo.
However, if persons are wanted and we get information as to the whereabouts, we will go and we will take them into custody. But it's in a general way a CANU investigation.
On Friday, CANU in a statement said the truck driver and porters were arrested after 48 kilograms of cocaine were found in dressed lumber. The statement added that the bust, which has a street value of $550 million, was loaded in a truck laden with several pallets of 1x6 dressed lumber destined for the United States. According to CANU, several lumbers were collected and drilled randomly, which revealed a whitish substance packaged neatly, suspected to be cocaine. The unit added that the driver and porters were detained and subsequently released after assisting with the investigation. CANU further stated that their investigation revealed that the truck was hired to pick up and transport the lumber from the Rhines Lal's sawmill at Lookout East Bank Essequibo to a wharf at Georgetown. CANU further said it had arrested race car driver Nizam Ghafoor and was looking for a well-known biker Stephen Vera and Naren Lal, among others. Searches were conducted at the homes of Stephen Vera and Naren Lal, however, they have not been found. Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
A warning has been issued by the Government Analyst Food and Drug Department against the purchase of Dose Patent Barley, which has been packed and distributed by Gitanjali Rai, Guyana.
The warning follows an investigation which was initiated as a result of concerns raised and complaints lodged at a National Food Safety and Committee meeting. This is according to Deputy Director of the Government Analyst Food and Drug Department, Joel Sears. As such, an analyst was conducted by the Food Chemistry Laboratory, which confirmed that the product was adulterated with wheat and flour. According to Sears, the adulterated product is dangerous for toddlers' consumption as well as adults.
No analysis, the analysis are done, are determined due to the characteristic of the product. So there are different types of analysis for different types of products. As a matter of fact, this could not have been done on a liquid product. Right? This analysis is done on cereals, particularly cereals.
Further, inspectors will be dispatched to the coastland areas where the product is said to be largely available to seize them. Moreover, consumers are advised not to purchase the particular brand of patent barley.
The investigations would have revealed he's one of the producers of the product. And so we advising consumers while investigations are continuing not to buy the product.
Environmental health officers in the regions will also be targeting for investigation or the brands to be submitted to the department for analysis. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
The mayor and town council of Linden owes over $200 million to various companies, monies that have accumulated over the years. It is against this backdrop that the mayor of Linden, Carwin Holland, is asking the government to bail out the council.
The bauxite mining town of Linden is asking for a bailout from the government as it has debts outstanding that have been accumulated during the time of the past council. Mayor of Linden, Carwin Holland, said that over $200 million is needed to take them out of the crisis. He also said that the other towns have been granted their request many times and is asking that the same be done for Linden.
Right now we need over $200 million. We need a bailout. A bailout. We inherited over, when we came into office, a very young group, enthusiastic group of councillors staring us down was over $200+ million in red, you know, and we're faced with that until today. However, we've started to make little payments towards that. We are indebted to NIS, GRE, and, you know, several persons. And it is a monkey on our backs, which we need to get off.
He also said that a letter was sent to the Ministry of Communities requesting the sum, and he is awaiting a response.
I did send a letter asking for the bailout, all right, and it's something that we are going to be awaiting answers. The Ministry of Communities would have received that request, and so we're going to await word on that.
However, in November 2016, the mayor and the city council had requested $600 million from the government, claiming that they are cash-strapped and needed the funds to pay workers in December. The request was denied.
More news still ahead. Stay with us.
Over 64 years, Gafoors has been your number one hardware supplier. And today, we're the largest manufacturer of PVC and plastic products in Guyana. We produce pipes Schedule 40, DWV, SDR 21 and SDR 26 in sizes 1/2 inch to 12 inches. Electrical conduits, PVC gutters in 9-foot 6 inches and 16-foot lengths. Water tanks, sizes from 200 gallons to 1600 gallons. Stackable water tanks for easy transportation, size 450 gallons. Pipes and gutter fittings, which include elbows, adapters, tees, straps and brackets, and buckets, bottles and containers with covers in various sizes. Our PVC and plastic products are available at any of our several locations and at many hardware stores countrywide. Gafoors, the name you can trust.
I'm going to be strong.
I'm going to do great.
I'm going to be my best.
Good nutrition makes a difference. Lasco Food Drink gives you protein for muscle strength, calcium for bone strength, vitamins, minerals, and iron to keep you healthy.
Go!
Packed with nutrition, Lasco Food Drink. Make your day.
Distributed by Ansemakal Trading Limited.
Impressions, we are the experts when it comes to creative marketing, brand campaigns, concept development, and production.
With our diverse knowledge and tactical marketing strategies, we are the go-to company to reignite your brand. Having been in the industry for over 20 years, we're Ghana's number one choice for brand development.
Do you
have a business idea and don't know where to start?
Do you have a small business that has been stagnated and not growing? iPad can provide finance for as much as $20 million for you to acquire equipment, tools, machinery, and stocks to start or expand your business.
iPad can also provide mentoring and training for you to improve your business skills, marketing, and record keeping.
iPad, improving livelihoods.
Get going, keep growing with iPad.
Update. Welcome back. The U.S. State Department has released its 2017 International Narcotics Control Strategy Report, which stated that Guyana continues to be an attractive country for both human and drug trafficking. Details in this report.
The report stated that Guyana continues to be a transit country for a South American cocaine destined for Europe, the United States, Canada, West Africa, and the Caribbean. In the report, it was highlighted that many criminals use cash couriers or familiar networks to move large sums of money between Guyana and the United States. Unregulated currency exchange houses also pose a risk as they are used both for the exchange of currency and to transfer funds to and from the diaspora. Additionally, casinos are legal in Guyana and pose a risk for money laundering. However, Guyana has one casino. The report stated that the primary sources of laundered funds are believed to be narcotics trafficking and corruption. However, the laundering of proceeds from other illicit activities, such as human trafficking, contraband, illegal natural resource extraction, and tax evasion, is substantial. In 2013, the Caribbean Financial Action Task Force issued a public statement noting significant strategic deficiencies in Guyana's anti-money laundering regime, and declaring Guyana a money laundering risk to the international financial system. Subsequently, the government created an action plan to address noted deficiencies and in mid-2015 passed amendments to update its AML legislation. In 2016, the CFATF removed Guyana from its public statement. Although AML legislation gives the Financial Intelligence Unit authority to investigate alleged money laundering, the unit does not have the capacity to conduct such investigations. Instead, the Special Organized Crime Unit, SOCU, investigates those cases referred to it by the FIU. Additionally, lack of cooperation by the business community also hinders Guyana's AML efforts. However, the State Department recognizes the work of SOCU, which seized approximately $80,000 worth of local and foreign currency and arrested two persons suspected of money laundering. Nikhil Jondo reporting for MTV News Update.
A massive number of sugar workers once again demonstrated their strong opposition to the plan by the government and the Guyana Sugar Corporation to close the Rosal estate by year end.
That was the scene this morning as workers continue to struggle through protest action, joined by housewives, business persons, students and pensioners at Rose Hall, Barbies. This follows the decision by the coalition to keep only three of the six existing sugar estates come 2018. According to a statement from the Guyana Agricultural and General Workers Union, GAU, The government's plan for sugar has triggered a spate of protests in the Sugar Belt as workers fathom the dire consequences of closure. The protesters also demonstrated fear that their peaceful communities would be destroyed, families displaced, and there will be increased incidences of crime and other social ills. GAO's Vice President Harvey Tamron explained how the decision will affect workers.
This area here has no opportunity for other work besides the game business. Working in the industry in the Sugar Belt is all that most of the sugar workers know of. They know how to cut the cane and weed the grass and fertilize the cane and to work in the factory. They are not skilled people that can go out and market themselves. So the government ought to take this into consideration.
While the workers were not prepared for such a plan from the government, Tamron noted workers will continue to picket as they will not give in to the closure of more estates.
This is an issue of bread and butter for the people, for the workers, their families. People who will be affected are hire car drivers, vendors in the market, the small business people, the large business people, school children, sugar workers and their immediate family. They will be destroyed. They will have separation in homes.
Rose Hall Estate, according to data from Gaisuku, employs some 2,300 workers, and assuming a family size of 4, about 10,000 persons of the country's population will be directly impacted by the closure decision. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
The Hinterland Electrification Company Incorporated has finally delivered both Port Kaitumas and Madias transformer. In December 2015, a contract was awarded for the procurement of two electrical transformers for the two communities. The units, which cost a total of $6 million, are part of the infrastructure needed to upgrade the electricity service provided to the two hinterland communities. According to the government's news agency, the transformers only for redundancy purposes. It is to be used in emergency cases, especially if the current transformer is damaged or stops working. In an effort to promote development within the Nine Tongues, a two-day conference will be hosted for the nine mayors under the theme Positioning Municipalities as Critical Partners in National Development.
The municipalities of Guyana will be hosting a two-day municipality conference on May 19 and 20. This is to showcase the wealth of the municipalities and to create opportunities for networking between the tongues to make Guyana better. Mayor of Linden and the chairman of the Guyana Association of Municipalities, Carwin Holland, said that mayors of the nine municipalities have been working together in unity to have the networking of towns strong.
National development. And I must say that this inaugural conference, it will showcase the wealth of each of Guyana's municipalities, create opportunities for networking, and it will provide a forum for discourse on key government issues affecting Guyana's nine municipalities. And pivotal to the agenda that we've set will be the advancement towards capital towns and incorporating a green economy framework, which our president envisions. We must say that we are pleased we've reached this far, in which mayors from the nine municipalities would have worked together in oneness and in unity with one shared vision.
Meanwhile, Mayor of Bartica, Gifford Marshall, expressed his gratitude for such a conference, reminding that Bartica has only attained the township for a year now. He also said that the municipalities will develop strategies to overcome challenges they face.
As you're aware, we're just 1 year old and we need help. We need to build our capacity And of course, we're looking forward for networking with the other municipalities, because we know and the evidence shows that our challenges are the same, like Mayor Holland would have mentioned. And the only way we can overcome the challenges is if we come together and work together to offset these challenges. For example, for our financial status, the positions of the council, of course, remains a concern for most of the municipalities. And getting persons to pay their rates and taxes, getting persons to adapt to the relevant changes, especially in the new towns, remain a major challenge for us.
Stay tuned for regional and international news as well as Court Roundup.
And see you cheering!
Join MTV Channel 14 Cable 65 from April 5 to May 21 for the most spectacular T20 cricket, the 10th Vivo Indian Premier League 2017. All matches, including the qualifiers and final, will be televised. Watch 8 excellent teams compete: Sunrisers Hyderabad, Royal Challengers Bangalore, Kolkata Knight Riders and others. Place your commercials during these super matches. Call now, let's design a package that suits your budget. For further details, please call your advertising agency or our friendly marketing team on 226-3593 or 225-0569.
Guyana. The Central Housing and Planning Authority, under the patronage of the Government of Guyana, brings to you Housing Solutions 2017 and Beyond Expo, a model village of modern, stylish, and affordable housing designs. Prospective homeowners, here is your opportunity to engage with the banking and other financial institutions as well as insurance companies to discuss available financing options. The public will experience and enjoy wholesome entertainment for the entire family and savor the flavor of local and foreign cuisine as well as beverages at the food court. So tell a family, tell a friend, and come visit Model Village. Housing Solutions 2017 and Beyond opens on Friday, May 26 at 15 hours and runs from May 27 to 29, time 11 to 22 hours each day at the Perseverance Housing Development Site on the east bank of Demerara. Not too sure where that is? Just follow the Massey and Princess Hotel Road. This event is sponsored by Geico Construction, Guyana Bank for Trade and Industry, Republic Bank, Turgenol, New Building Society, and Courts.
Expo, be there.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any 5 numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick fix for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Hey, you have a growing flesh there, and there too, and there is another one. Those ugly and annoying growing flesh, like a plague, ignoring them, and before you know, you have them everywhere. SlimJet, presenting Coleomac, the most effective growing flesh and wart remover. Painlessly remove ugly growing flesh is the quick and effective way. Get soft, smooth, growing flesh-free skin, guarantee. Just apply Coleomac twice a day and the growing flesh just dry up and fall off. Easy, quick, and painless. Stop suffering and feeling embarrassed. Remove those ugly growing flesh with Coleomac. Only at the SlimJet, City Mall, second floor, or in New Amsterdam, 22 Asylum and Main Road, Berbice.
that went down at the Georgetown Magistrates Courts on Tuesday, May 16.
A 26-year-old Stabroek vendor was this morning remanded on the charge of trafficking narcotics. Travis Alexander of 109 Danrach Street in Newtown appeared in the Georgetown Magistrates' Courts before Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan. The charge against Alexander alleged that on May 12 at the Stabroek Market, he had 23 grams of marijuana in his possession for the purpose of trafficking. The unrepresented man denied the allegation after it was read to him. The prosecution objected to bail since no special reason was given by the defendant. The prosecution also said that Alexander had allegedly robbed someone and was positively identified. Police conducted a search on his person and unearthed a black plastic bag that contained leaves, seeds and stems suspected to be marijuana. Meanwhile, a former corporal attached to the Guyana Defense Force has been committed to stand trial at the High Court in Georgetown for rape. Winston Haynes, who was represented by attorney at law Dexter Todd, is accused of raping a young woman in January at Army Base Camp Stevenson to marry East Bangdamarara. According to information, the young woman was allegedly raped by the former soldier in the presence of two of his colleagues who have since been dismissed from the Army. The woman was only allowed to leave after another Army personnel at Camp Stevenson intervened. The Director of Public Prosecutions had recommended that only Haynes be charged, even though the two other ranks were initially accused. Haynes, who is out on $600,000 bail, will go before a judge and jury at the next practicable sitting of the Demerara Assizes. Finally, Kemendra Ragabir and Anil Prasad appeared before Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan, accused of bribing a police constable at the Bergdam Police Station. Ragabir of Lot 171 C Fields Sophia and Anil Prasad, 24, also of Sophia, pleaded not guilty to the charge which alleged that on May 12 at Bergdam Police Station, they corruptly gave $500,000 to Police Constable Gerald Rodriguez as inducement to release Michael Ragabir from police custody. Michael Ragabir is the son of Kemendra Ragabir. Police prosecutor Arvin Moore told the court that the defendants acted in concert. According to a police report, Michael Ragabir was earlier arrested for unlawful possession of a firearm and ammunition. He is one of two suspects who had escaped from police, dropping their firearm in the process. The 19-year-old was caught and arrested when his father, Kemendra Ragabir, was busted in a sting operation, bribing the policeman. The defendants were each released on $200,000 bail and ordered to report to the Criminal Investigation Department at the Bergdam Police Station until the determination of the matter. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Let's turn our attention to the Demerara Harbor Bridge schedule. That sums up our newscast for the night, but before we go, here's a recap of our major headlines. Linden Town Council needs $200 million bailout from government. Cancer is the main cause of mortality in Guyana. Stephen Fair nowhere to be found as Kanu continues to search. Rosehall sugar workers stage mass protest against the estate's closure. Municipalities conference to be held to foster development in the nine towns. And in court, former soldier to stand trial in the High Court for rape. The newscast can be viewed online on our MTV's Facebook page and also on our YouTube channel. The news will be rebroadcasted later tonight at 23 hours and at 6 hours on Wednesday, May 17. On behalf of our news team, I am Trisha Ramlal, thanking you for watching. Remember, suicide is never the answer, as problem comes and goes. Good night.